In this session, we'll see source coding algorithms. The first one is Shannon's encoding algorithm with the examples. Let us see what are the steps to perform the source encoding using Shannon's encoding algorithm. So given the set of symbols, the first procedure is to arrange the symbols given to you in non-increasing probabilities. Okay, not increasing, but non-increasing. That means you're going to arrange in decreasing probabilities. Next, you're going to compute the sequence alpha 1, alpha 2, and so on with these equations, where P will be the P1, P2 are the probability of the symbols given. Next, determine the smallest integer of Li using the inequality 2 power Li greater than or equal to 1 by Pn. Expand the decimal number of alpha I, whatever you have calculated, alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3. You have to expand those and in binary forms up to Li places, neglecting beyond Li places. Remove the binary point to get the decimal code. So as per these five steps, we'll go to the example for encoding algorithm, that is using Shannon's encoding algorithm, and also find the code efficiency and redundancy. So apply Shannon's encoding algorithm to following set of messages. That means we have five messages been given. So first step of Shannon's encoding tells us we have to arrange the symbols given according to non-increasing probabilities. So very easy for us is we have two denominators with 16. So we arrange all with such that all denominators will be 16. So 1 by 8, 1 by 8, I arrange as 2 by 16. This will be 1 by 16. This is 3 by 16. This will be 4 by 16. This will be 6 by 16. So it will be very easy for me to arrange these set of symbols or messages given in decreasing probabilities. So first one will be non-increasing probabilities, means it should go on decreasing. So first should be the highest one, highest message. So 6 is 6 by 16 is the first one. So arrange 6 by 16. Where it is P1 now. Next higher is 4 by 16, P2. Next is P3, 3 by 16. Next is 2 by 16, P4 and P5. So first step of Shannon's encoding algorithm is over, where we are arranging in terms of non-increasing or decreasing probabilities. Next, I have to compute the sequences of alphas. So first one given here is in our steps algorithm, alpha 1 is 0. So I write alpha 1 as 0. What is alpha 2 in our step? Alpha 2 is alpha 1 plus p1. So alpha 1 plus p1, alpha 2 is alpha 1 plus p1. Alpha 1 is 0. What is alpha 2? 0 plus p1, that is 6 by 16. I get 0.375. Next, alpha 3. Alpha 3 will be P2 plus alpha 2, you can write, or P2 plus P1 and so on. So P2 is 6 by 16, P1, and I get this. Alpha 4, P3 plus alpha 3. This also you can write as P2 plus, it is nothing but P2 plus alpha 2. One and the same, P2 plus P1 or P2 plus alpha 2. Alpha 5 is P4 plus alpha 4. You can see here, alpha 2 is P1 plus alpha 1. So I can write alpha I plus 1. Alpha I plus 1 equal to pi plus alpha. In general, we write this. Correct? Because alpha 4 is I is equal to 3. Alpha 4 is P3 plus alpha 3. Alpha 4 is alpha 5 is P4 plus alpha 4, alpha 6. Until I get this one, I should go on doing the additions. So sequence of alphas are generated. That was our second step. Third step is find the smallest integer of alpha 1, alpha Li. Li is found by using the equality 2 power Li is 1 by Pi. By I is equal to what now? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. I is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Because alpha 6 is equal to 1. We need not consider that. Okay. So now, when it is 1, we are not considering. Only till alpha 5 we are considering. So I is 1 to 5. When I is equal to 1. When I is equal to 1 means what? When I is equal to 1 means 2 power L1 greater than or equal to 1 by Pi. This equation has what? 1 by Pi. What is Pi? I is 1 means Pi is 1 by P1 is what? P1 is 6 by 16. So it will be 16 by 6. So here this will be equal to 2.66. So I should satisfy this equality. To satisfy this equality, that is 2 power L1, whatever I get this should be greater than or equal to 2.66. To satisfy this, this should be, if L1 is equal to 1, what happens? 2 is not greater than. This equality doesn't hold good. So if L2 is 2, it becomes 4. Yes, 4 is greater than 2.66. So L1 is 2. Okay. Next, 2 power L2 is greater than 1 by P2. What is P2? 4 by 16. So 1 by P2 means 16. So here 2 power L2 is greater or equal to 4. In order to satisfy this equality, what L2 should be equal to? 2. Similarly, 2 power Li should be greater or equal to 1 by P3. P3 is 3 by 16. So 1 by P3 means 16 by 3. And this is equal to L3 should be equal to 3. Similarly, for I is 4 and I is 5. We are calculating what is the length. Now, the decimal numbers, fourth step. So, first step is in decreasing probability, we are arranging. We are calculating alpha I by using these equations. Next, 2 power Li greater or equal to 1 by Pi. We are finding the L1, L2, L3 and so on. In the fourth step, we are expanding the alpha I's up to Li places. Now, alpha 1 is 0. Alpha 2, 0.4375 to the base 10. That is what we have got here. Correct. That has to be converted to binary. How do we convert to binary? 0.375 into 2, 0.75 carry is 0. 0.75 into 2 is 1.50, carry is 1. I write 0.50, carry is 1. 0.50 into 2 is 1.0, carry is 1. Now I write this from top to bottom. That is the conversion from decimal to binary procedure. I get 0.011 to the base 2. Similarly, I convert alpha 3, 0.625. How much is that? Next, I convert alpha 4. I should stop when I get this here. I should stop this conversion. I should stop this conversion. Okay. Similarly, I go for alpha 5 also. After alpha 4, I go for alpha 5. Okay, I get this, right? So now alpha 4 and alpha 5 also I get. Now what happens? We are able to see once we get this, okay, alpha 1 is 0. And what is for alpha I? See the fourth step. Fourth step tells you decimal numbers alpha I are expanded in binary form up to Li places. That means for alpha 1, Li, L1. For alpha 2, L2. Okay. So now when I have alpha 1 with me, it is 0. L1 is 2 places. So I'm writing S1 as 0, 0. Alpha 2, I get 0.011 after conversion from decimal to binary. Correct. And what is L2? L2, I've got it as 2. From where did I get L2 equations? From this to satisfy these equalities. Okay. So here I get L2 is equal to 2. So I write only 0, 1 by neglecting the decimal point. L3 is 3. I write 1, 0, 3 by neglecting the decimal point. So we have determined here. We can see here for this L4, how much should be this L4 to satisfy equal to or greater than condition? So greater than condition, if I substitute 2 power 2, it becomes 4. It will not be satisfied. Okay. If I substitute 3, 2 power 3, 8. Equal to condition is satisfied. So L4 is equal to 3. In that way, we have calculated L1, L2, L3, L4, L5. Next, alpha 4 is this. Now L4 is 3. So I get 1, 1, 0. L5 is 4 and this is my alpha 5. I get 4 ones. So now I write as per my decreasing order itself. I have written what are the probabilities and what are the codes. L1, 0, 0. L201, correct. Next, L3101, 110, 104. And what are the L1, L2, L3? 2, 3, 3, and 4. This is what I have got the coding. This is how the code words are generated for the symbols. For M1, see the code word. For M2, 1110. For M3, 101. For M4, 01. For M5, zero zero. This is an algorithm which is assigning the symbols with the code words. Now, how you find the average length? I is 1 to q pi into li. So, what is I? 1 to 5. So, here p1 into p1 l1. What is p1? What is p1? p1 is 3 by 8. p1 is 3 by 8 into li is 2. p2 is 1 by 4 into l2. 3 by 16 into l3, l4, l5. So, I get this bits per message symbol as average length l. Entropy, pi log 1 by pi. So, p1, p2, p3 up till p4, p5 log of 1 by p1. So, when I substitute, what is p1? 3 by 8 plus log of 3 by 8. 1 by 4 plus log of 4. 3 by 16 plus log of 16 by 3. In that way, when I substitute in this equation, as we have done entropy in the module 1, I get entropy. Code efficiency is entropy by average length. Redundancy is 1 minus efficiency. This is how we do problems on Shannon's encoding algorithm. Coming to the next problem, apply Shannon's encoding algorithm for the following messages 0.3, 0.2, 0.3, 0.3, and 0.2. Find the code efficiency and redundancy. It's the same procedure we have done now. So let me first arrange in decreasing probabilities. This is 0.5. Okay, 0.5, 0.3, and 0.2. So let me arrange 0.5, 0.3, 0.2. It is already given in decreasing probability, so I have arranged it. Next, I'll calculate what is alpha 1, 0, alpha 2, alpha 1 plus p1, 0.1, alpha 3, p2 plus alpha 2, 0.3 plus 0.5, 0.3, alpha 4, p3 plus alpha 3, 1. So I have l1, l2, l3, l4. So now 2 power l1 greater or equal to 1 by p1. Okay, what is p1? 1 by 0.5, that is equal to 2. So this equality to be satisfied, L1 should be equal to 1. So that these are either equal or greater, equal. Next, 1 by P2 for L2. What is P2? 0.3, 1 by 0.3, 0.3, 0.33. For this to be condition to be greater, L2 should be equal to 2. That means 4 greater than this. So L2 is 2. Next, 0.3 again. That is 1 by 0.2. 1 by 0.2 is 5. Okay. So here this should be satisfied. This equality means this should be 8. 4, no L1, no L2, L3 can't be 1, L3 can't be 2, but L3 can be 3. This condition is satisfied. So L3 equal to 3. Once I get these, now I will convert whatever alphas are there in binary and extend up to the decimal points. Alpha 1 is 0. Alpha 2 is 0.5. Only one thing is possible. I have to stop once I get this. So it is alpha 3 is 0.8. If we are not able to get 1.00 after 3 multiplications, we can stop there itself. So alpha 3 I have stopped here itself, 0.110. So now alpha 1 is 1, alpha 1 is 0, L1 is 1, so S1 is only one code word. Alpha 2, we see it is 0.1 to the base 2. And what is L2? L2 is 2. So it should be equal to 1, 0. Next, actually this continues. This continues here because I don't get 1.00 there. Okay. So here L3 is equal to 3. So I get 1, 1, 0. So for 0.5, what is the code? 0. For 0.3, 1, 0. 1, 1, 0. This is how we are going to assign using an algorithm. And these are the length what we have got, L1, L2 up till L3 for the symbols given. Then I calculate average length using equation pi li. Pi li gives from this table 0.5 into 1 plus 0.3 into 2 plus 0.2 into 3. Correct. Next, pi log 1 by pi. So here I have pi 0.5 log 1 by 0.5 plus 0.3 log 1 by 0.3 plus 0.2 log 1 by 0.2, and all log r to the base 2. That is what we are doing throughout. I get entropy. Efficiency is entropy by average length. Average length is 1.7. And redundancy is 1 by efficiency. 1 minus efficiency gives me redundancy.